If you're getting the EA.com unable to connect error while trying to run games published by EA, then we know how to fix it. Watch this video till the end and learn how to solve this problem. Hey, you're watching Silicophilic, the home of all tech solutions. Network connection and server issues are common for Origin and Electronic Arts. This mainly happens when the servers get overloaded, but there are other possible causes for it. Here we have shown the troubleshooting you need to perform in order to fix this error. So stick till the end and perform as shown. Before we get into the solutions, subscribe to our channel for future tech support. Also, like this video if it helps you solve this issue. Don't forget to comment your feedback on the solutions or if you're facing any issue while performing them. We also have a Facebook group of troubleshooting experts where you can share your tech issues and get direct help. The link to the group is in the pinned comment. Now, let's jump into the solutions. Before you move on to the advanced steps, check the server status of Apex Legends. Also check the live server status of your gaming platforms like PlayStation Network, Xbox Live, Nintendo. You can do this by visiting their social media handles or visiting the Down Detector website and searching their servers in the search bar. Also check if you're getting a stable network connection. Perform a speed test and see if your internet speed is good enough. Method 2. After checking the server status, if EA Sports is still unable to connect, then check if your EA membership is active. If you have taken EA Play membership and your membership has expired, then you will not be able to play the games. You will have to reactivate your membership first and then see if you can play the game without the connection error. Method 3. If you get any notification that your account is already in use, then log out of your EA account from all the devices you use and log in back. If the game is being played on another device with your EA account, then you will not be able to play it. Method 4. Another thing you can try is restart your router as well as your gaming console to refresh the connection. If you are using a PC, give it a fresh restart. Turn off the power of the router and the console. Disconnect the power cables and keep them unplugged for a couple of minutes. Then connect the cables and turn them on. Method 5. If the router is kept far away from the gaming device, it might lead to connection issues and cause this problem. So keep the router near your device and also make sure there is no electronic interference between your device and the router. Method 6. The next thing you can try is flushing the DNS and resetting the network settings on your PC. Search for CMD in the Windows search bar and run it as administrator. Type in ipconfig /flushdns in the command prompt and press enter. Next, type ipconfig /release and press enter. Next, type ipconfig /renew and press enter. Finally, type netsh winsock reset catalog and press enter. Method 7. Another thing you can try is changing the DNS. Here is how you can do it. Press the Windows plus R keys to open run command. Type ncpa.cpl and press enter to open network connections. Right-click on your network connection and open its properties. Click on Internet Protocol version 4 and open its properties. set the preferred DNS server address to 8.8.8.8 and alternate DNS server address to 8.8.4.4. Save your changes by clicking on the OK. If this does not solve your problem, then move on to the next solution. Method 8. The next thing you can try is disabling the proxy server. Enter Internet Options in the search menu and open the top option. Go to the Connections tab and click on LAN Settings. Find and uncheck the box attached to Use Proxy Servers for your LAN option. Click on OK to save the changes. Method 9. Network Profile configures Windows Firewall Protection. If you have set the network profile to the public option, then your firewall protection may not allow any connection that is not done manually. Getting a false positive, the firewall can block your game. So change your network profile to private and see if it solves the problem. Go to the right bottom corner of your screen and click on network icon. Click on Network and Internet Settings option. Expand the properties of your internet adapter. Select private as your network profile. Restart your PC. So that's it. If this video has helped you in figuring this issue, then give us a like and subscribe to our channel. If the issue isn't resolved from the solutions we have shown here, comment below to let us know. And our team will try their best to help you out. Also join our Facebook group for direct tech support. The link to the group is in the pinned comment. Thanks for watching Silicophilic.